Hello. In life, you never know when you're going to need to know how to knot a tie, whether it's for your husband, son, or even yourself. Today, I'm going to demonstrate how to knot a Windsor knot and the variations of different knots and tips. Okay, so first, we're going to start with the steps. All you're going to need is a tie and a person, myself. So, what you're going to do, wrong way, is you're gonna put the tie around your neck. Make sure that the wider side is longer than the skinny side. And then you're gonna cross the wide side over. Yes. So it'll look like this now. Then I'm gonna wrap it behind. Yeah, that's what we do. Put it in here. Okay, did y'all see that? I put it through the loop, right? And then next, gotta make sure this is straight the whole time, or else it's gonna come out funky. So, what we're gonna do is wrap this around the front so it looks like this, but like, leave fingers in here so that when you bring it, okay, I'm explaining this wrong, but it's okay. So we're gonna wrap it around. Make sure you leave your fingers there so you have room. And after you wrap it around, you're gonna bring it through the middle, right? And then put it through the loop. And then just pull the wider side to adjust it to how you want it to look. And then pull the smaller one to make it tighter. And you got yourself a knot, period. I did that. Next, I'm going to talk about the different variations of knots. There are a lot of different types of neckwear knots. The four in hand knot is really easy. I'm going to have a picture right here. And then the half Windsor knot, it's the one I did, but it's easier than that. It's easier. And then a bow tie, I really want to learn how to do a bow tie. I feel like it's really easy though. And then the boltless knot is very uncommon, but it seems easy. So I'm in a different location, had some technical difficulties, but as I was saying, another type of knot is the Merle knot. This one is really different from the one that I demonstrated because the skinnier side of the tie is in the front instead of the back. Like in a regular tie, it's in the front. Yeah. Now I'm gonna share different tips for how to get the perfect tie, like mine was. So, you always have to have the wider side of the tie longer than this side, about 4 inches should be enough. When you're making the knot, don't wrap too tight around or else it's gonna get harder, gonna be harder to put everything in place at the end. And then at the end, when you're tightening it, don't squeeze the knot and pull the thinner side. You need to pull this side, not this side. So earlier I stated that you never know when you're going to need to know how to knot a tie. Well, today I hope that my demonstration helped you learn how to do it. Thank you for listening.